As you can see today, I am doing a bride makeup look.
And it was a request.
I do a champagne and wine color makeup look for a bride.
This is
what I came up with, and you guys will see that on my tutorial. I had to use several colors to come up with this color.
I just want to mention a few things about bridal makeup.
With bridal makeup, you want to emphasize your eyes. You want to create a little drama, just not over dramatic, just because on your pictures, if you look a little too natural, you won't be able to tell too much.
You want to create
a little bit of that drama to be able to reflect.
Another thing is, you
want
to
make sure you use a very good primer on your face before you apply foundation and a good powder, because that's going to help your makeup stay on
all day.
Of course, primer on your eyes is very important. It is very important that you highlight your eye, and when you apply your concealer or foundation, if possible, use two tones of a foundation. Use your regular tone foundation as normal, and then try to use a lighter one around this area, and then of course highlight your higher cheekbones, all of this area here. It is great to highlight on brides, again, and that's because of pictures. It is picture perfect. When you highlight all of this area on your face, your pictures look stunning, and of course highlights the inner
corner. All right, guys,
thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys like this look, and if you have any requests, please feel free to send them to me, and I'll be more than happy to put them together.
So the first thing we're gonna do is very important, is to apply a primer base on your
eyelid. Is it helps your makeup stay on, not crease, and
applying
look vibrant.
The primer with my Sigma brush. That's why this concealer brush, large concealer brush, is so cool, because in no time you get your stuff done, and that's the Sigma brush, the F65.
Our next step is going to be, I'm using the new and infillable 24 hour eyeshadow, and the color I'm using is Ice Latte, which is like a
very
champagne
pretty
color. And I'm going to be applying that with my large fluff brush from Sigma, which is the E50,
starting with the top.
Our next step is going to be Studio Secrets Professional, and it's this one here, and the one I'm using is Electrified.
And as you can see, it is these colors here.
And I'm going to
be
using small tapered E45, that looks like that, okay. And I'm going to start on the very end of the eye, creating kind of like a triangle, just like that. Now we're going to take a matte black color,
color Onyx.
Now this
black
is my MAC 266, and the brush looks like this.
Start here at the end and kind of work my way into the crease. Doesn't have to be perfect, because we're going to be blending this in
take
just a second.
The E45 again, which is this one here, and we're going to blend that as well. Blend, blend, blend. Okay. Now I'm going to
Pro
use
palette.
My. Okay, and the color I'm going to pick up is going to be this color here. It's kind of like a purple, kind of like a purple bluish a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna pick up just a little bit of that color, and I'm going to apply it all over here. Blend, blend, blend.
Then I'm going to pick up a little bit
this lighter color
here, which is like another purple, but it's just a tad
lighter.
And again, this is to create that
so
wine
now
color.
I'm going to go ahead and take from a hip
dual palette as well that comes in it. I'm gonna take this one here, which is like a skin tone, just a little bit darker. Okay, and we're gonna apply that skin tone right above those colors that we've been applying, and that's just to make sure that we're blending. Next color properly. We're picking up is from the same Pro palette that I just used, and we're picking up this red here. It's kind of like a matte red. We're picking a little bit of that up.
Apply it right over this area.
Now we're going to take Figma E25, which is the blending brush, and we're going to take a little bit more of the skin tone
and color. We're going to start blending away more.
Now we're going to take tapered brush again, just this one here, and we're going to go ahead and pick up on that.
We're going to
do this. Tapered blending brush, the E35.
And then we're going to blend a little bit.
Now we're going to take our short shader brush from Sigma as well,
E20.
And we're going to pick up on the same color. We're going to apply it on our lower lash line. Take this brush and we're going to kind of blend that color. Now we're going to take the same brush here and we're going to pick up a little bit of that same red that we picked up earlier, just a tiny bit, and then we're going to take it and we're going to go over this bottom line with that brush. Might have lost a little bit of that highlight color we used earlier. L'Oreal. I'm gonna pick up a brush. It's not a Sigma brush, but the brush looks like this. And because we might have lost a little bit of that color, I'm just gonna reapply it a little bit here on my brow bone.
Color it down a little bit.
And we're gonna do my next jumbo pencil in color Milk. And I'm going to apply it on the very corner of my eye. All over my eye, this corner area, and I'm gonna apply it like that.
I'm using my L'Oreal with this brush
to apply some of that. That is to make me look brighter and more awake. It looks beautiful on pictures, gorgeous, beautiful. It makes your eyes look really bright. Now, also in the process, you might have lost some of the same color on this area, and we're just gonna reapply a little bit of it on that area. Okay. Blending brush that looks like this. Just slightly gonna blend this all in. Very slightly, very softly. No pressure on the brush. On the waterline, we're gonna use the same Milk pencil.
It's always best to
highlight with white eyeliner versus black, because white liner makes you look more awake, makes your eye look brighter. So much awake. What we're going to do is apply the eyeliner.
I'm going to be using
my Sigma eyeliner brush.
I'm using my Sephora gel liner in color black.
Highlight liner. Looks like that. Okay, we're almost finished. So our next step is going to be apply our mascara, apply our false lashes. So guys, this is the final look. I put the lashes on. I also applied some mascara on the false lashes and on the bottom lashes.
Hope you guys liked it, and until next time, un beso. Ciao.